What are multi-train takt plans? In this video, I'm going to talk to you about what a single train takt plan is and what a multi-train takt plan is. As I start, I do want you to know that this content is available in a Canva graphic in the description. I will also link you to a podcast about it. And this is available in the book Takt Planning, and there's expanded content in the book Takt Steering and Control. So I'm going to be doing lots of movements with my hands, and if you like that, if you're into that tactile kind of learning, this one-on-one, this close relationship, please like and subscribe to this video. You're going to love it. Okay. So a takt plan is a production plan in a time by location format showing time on the top, zones on the left. And you see these beautifully colored boxes that are in this parallelogram, right? And the reason you see that shape is because you see the train coming down through the zones as your takt time progresses in time. That's what creates that beautiful parallelogram shape, okay? That's what your takt plan is made of, time by location and the speed of the train. So if you see a takt phase that's long, it's going slow. If you see a takt phase that's tall, it's going fast. Okay, so what I want to talk to you about is this concept of a multi-train takt plan. When you see that shape, and again, I will give you resources in the description below, all you're seeing is a single train going through zones. You see, there's a misconception in this industry. People think in takt planning, takt time is the predominant factor. It's not. It's zones and phases. It's the location piece. A phase with zones can have different trains with multiple takt times, different takt times. It's totally fine. What it means is this. If you have zone 1, 2, 3, you have one train that's flowing through it, and then at a different time, at a different speed, or maybe the same speed, you have a different train. It's no different than in a real train analogy. You can have multiple trains working or running on the same tracks, sometimes in parallel. It's totally fine. It's not a big deal. So what you'll see is you'll see the shape of this train, but you also might see a different shape going at a different pace. Now, all you're seeing is two trains flowing through the same zones in the same phase, and it's totally fine because we don't lock ourselves into a 5-day takt time ever. We don't use the weekends as the takt time drumbeat for takt plans, and we don't have a problem with packaging trains where you have one activity split or multiple activities in a wagon. When you have two trains, that means this. That means that they will work better if they're going at separate speeds. Now, here's the key. When you have a multi-train takt plan, all you have to do is identify, instead of having a whole bunch of trains just all over the place with a chaotic schedule, attempt to loop those all in to a couple of consistent train lines or that look like this. All right, so that's all you have to do. If there's an activity next to your train line, magnetize it over so you can manage the work together. Okay, so then once you've magnetized, you'll want to move these train lines together, or you can overlap if need be, to where the lines, the trains, are pulled as close together as possible. Once you have those intersecting, you'll manage those connections and make sure that the interface or where they're working in a similar zone at the same time is in fact an accurate and responsible handoff. Then once you've done that, you'll make sure that your slowest speed is optimized and going the fastest possible, and you'll run the calculator off of that slowest train. So when you see LeanTakt takt plans, you won't see just one solid image. You will typically see multi-train analyses because we've gone through the steps of being able to configure a multi-train takt plan. Civil TAC plans are that way. Industrial TAC plans are that way. MEP TAC plans are that way. Even multifamily TAC plans are that way. Commercial project TAC plans are that way. Concrete TAC plans are that way. Exterior TAC plans are that way. So the bottom line is we have to be flexible. It's not the TAC time that's predominant. It's the zones and the phases. So what I want to tell you is that there was a project that was using TAC planning, and they're like, yeah, I got to be in 5-day TAC times. Don't do that. And they're like, yeah, I'm going to use the weekends. Don't do that. And they're like, it has to be a perfect flow. And the trade partners were like, well, that's not really how it flows. And so we taught that team, hey, get rid of the weekends. It doesn't have to be on a 5-day TAC time. You don't have to have one TAC time. These can all flow as they need to. Instead of forcing everything into one TAC time, you are focused, this is called a TAC time-based TAC plan. We were able to create a modified TAC plan with 3, 4, 5 trains. And this is called a resource-based TAC plan. As soon as they did that, all of the trade partners recognized their individual flow. It was all coordinated and linked properly. It started to be implemented in a realistic manner. They implemented zone control. They narrowed their overall total phase duration, and everybody started to keep the rhythm. And if there was a delay, they just moved it a day because they weren't locked within the weekends. So multi-train TAC planning is advanced TAC planning that's done by people who really know how to work package. And the question always comes, what's the TAC time? Each train has its own TAC time. Then the question comes, well, how to use the calculator if you have multiple TAC times? You optimize the slowest one first, and then everything else fits around it. That's the answer. So all of these concepts can still be used, and it's absolutely fantastic. So in the description below, again, I'm going to give you a Canva graphic, a podcast, and a link to both of our books, which explain this. You don't have to see that perfect rhythm. You can have a resource-based TAC plan with multiple trains, and it's totally fine. And in fact, most of the time, it will work better. So do not fall into the trap of thinking that you need to use your weekends as the TAC time drumbeat. Don't think you have to have one 5-day TAC time. Don't think you have to have one TAC time. And don't think that you must force a one-for-one with your trade to your package. You have a lot of variability. Just make sure that your overall plan makes sense, and you will have a wild amount of success, especially if you're following our graphics. I really, really hope you check out the resources below, and I wish you the best of luck for it. If it works, give us a like and a subscribe on this channel. I hope you've enjoyed this video. On we go.